In the video for part 6.2, we were looking at a transition matrix which tracked a population of smokers and non-smokers, and we were looking at an initial probability distribution that said that we started out with 40% of the population being smokers and 60% non-smokers. Let's see how you would work with this information using the matrix tool. Let's start by typing in our transition matrix. And let's echo it down below to see if it looks right. 9/10, 1/10 in the first row, 0.05 and 0.95 in the second row. Spacing up here doesn't really matter. The matrix tool will figure it out whether you put the blank spaces in it or not. So if I want something like the transition matrix raised to the third power, I can just do this. That gives me the transition matrix to the third power. Remember, we also have the option of working in fraction format. If we want to do fraction mode, the transition matrix appears that way. And if we want to go to the third power in fraction mode, this is what we have. Fraction mode generally doesn't work well if you get large powers, but it depends on how even the numbers are, of course. So just be willing to switch from one to the other depending on the nature of the problem you're working with. So, for example, the kind of information we could read out of T cubed would be, remember, smokers were state 1, non-smokers state 2. So looking right here, we would see that in 3 years, the probability of someone who was a smoker to start with being a non-smoker after 3 years would be approximately 0.25, about a one-fourth probability. Let's illustrate working with the initial probability distribution, the one that we had in the textbook example was what, 40% smokers and 60% non-smokers. So let's look at that initial probability distribution tracked over 3 years' time, which means we're going to be multiplying it times the transition matrix raised to the third power. And this is what we get when we do that, which shows that after 3 years have passed, starting with 40% smokers and 60% non-smokers, we would be reduced to about 37.5% smokers and 62.5% non-smokers. What if this trend were to continue for 20 years? By that time, the smoking fraction would have been reduced to about a third and the non-smokers to about two-thirds. The point, of course, is simply that you can, using the matrix tool, you can do whatever calculations you need with regard to multi-step transition probabilities by just raising the transition matrix to the appropriate power and introducing whatever initial probability distribution you like.